this year. You guys are watching NBA Now here live on Chat Sports. I'm your host, Harris Rubenstein. You can follow me on Twitter at SportsDean for all your NBA news and updates. So we just went through the top news and rumors from across the NBA. Let's now get into your guys' questions with another edition of our NBA mailbag. Let's start with Dan O'Brien. He asked, how long do you think it will take for the Kings to get into the playoffs? And do they have any chance at a big-name free agent next offseason? Well, I think it's going to take the Kings a long time to get into the playoffs. And I know that divisions don't really matter in the NBA, but to an extent they also kind of do, just based off your schedule. LeBron James is now in your division, Kings, for the next 4 years. And until the Kings actually get a legitimately elite player on their team, they're just going to sit at the bottom. Because not only are the Lakers in their division, so are the Warriors and the Clippers, who are probably going to end up with one, if not two, max free agents this upcoming offseason. So again, I know that divisions don't technically matter when it comes to making the playoffs in the NBA, but it's only going to be more difficult for the Kings to make it with their division getting better. And in terms of them signing a free agent, they're not going to get Durant. They're not going to get Kawhi. Kyrie, that's hilarious. They're definitely not getting Klay, and Jimmy Butler is going nowhere near the Sacramento Kings. I think they're still a year away, maybe 2 years away, from getting a legitimate NBA free agent. No elite player is just going to randomly sign with the Kings when they haven't won anything in, I don't know, 20 years? It's been a while. Let's get to our next question here. Who is your pick for the most improved player in the NBA? The most improved player award on a year-to-year basis goes to the player with the best story. 2 years ago, it went to Giannis because, you know, the Greek freak going from, you know, unheralded prospect to crazy NBA player. Last year was Victor Oladipo, who got traded away, you know, three times in 3 years, ended up making an all-star team with the Pacers. This year, the best story for most improved player is Markelle Fultz. Easily the best story for most improved player. Number one pick in the draft, completely forgets how to play basketball over the course of an NBA offseason, doesn't play for most of the season, works at all offseason long, gets a new jump shot, and ends up coming back as a very good NBA player. I think Markelle Fultz is going to end up being the sixth man for a Sixers team that'll probably end up winning around 55 games and end up being a top three seed in the East. He's a perfect pick for most improved player. Perfect pick. I don't really see another player in the NBA who's going to come out of nowhere. The only other player who I think could actually win this, it's not even most improved player, he'd win comeback player, would be Gordon Hayward. And again, that's not most improved player. But I think it'll end up being Markelle Fultz. Something that doesn't need more improvement, though, are these minutes in the main charts. Because they're already perfect. Head to comfortable.af for the most comfortable dress shirt on the internet. They are so unbelievably comfortable. I have 8 of these in my closet. 8. Because I don't need to wear anything else. I wear them to bed. I wear them to work. I wear them to the bar. I wear them everywhere. The most comfortable dress shirt anywhere on the internet. Thank you to Miz and Main for providing our clothing here at Chat Sports. Got a question here from Bray asking, what do you think the Lakers record will be this season? I went over this when I went through my NBA power rankings. I don't think the Lakers are going to end up winning 50 games this year. I think that's just a little too high of expectations. I have them going 49-33 and ending up being either the fourth or fifth seed in the Western Conference. I think the Lakers are going to be quite good. I really do. The team seems to have very good chemistry off the court. They all seem to get along. From what I'm hearing about their first practice, I should say, they all look very good. LeBron is in fantastic shape. Lonzo Ball has bulked up, as has Brandon Ingram. Kyle Kuzma's been working on his defense. They're bringing all these great veterans. The Lakers are going to be good this year, guys. The Lakers are going to be good. Watch out for them this year. They might not win exactly 50 games, but they will end up doing just fine this season. Got another question from Bray asking, who do you think will win the MVP this season? I've talked a little bit about this before. I was kind of leaning towards LeBron. I've actually changed my pick. I'm going with Anthony Davis. Absolutely. I think Anthony Davis is going to win the MVP this year. He is primed for the best season of his career. He was the best big man at basketball last year. He was the only player in the NBA to be nominated for both Defensive Player of the Year and Most Valuable Player, and I think it's going to be Anthony Davis. And if you use chatsports.com/bet, you go on BetDSI right now, they're giving some great odds for Anthony Davis to end up winning MVP. He's plus 500 to win MVP. He's third right now. That's easy. That is easy. You risk $10, you'll end up winning 50. That's just easy money. Go bet on Anthony Davis and let me know as well. We got a reaction poll. Who is going to win MVP in 2018-19 season. Give me a heart for LeBron James. Give me a like for James Harden. Give me a wow face for Anthony Davis. And give me a laughing face for Giannis. LeBron plus 300, James Harden plus 350, and Giannis a plus 700. You can bet on any of these guys to win MVP at chatsports.com/bet. Use that promo code LIVE120 for a 120% deposit bonus. Got another question from maybe the weirdest YouTube name I've ever seen. Subscribe to instantly die, saying, where do you think Jimmy Butler will be traded to and for what? And what other big names do you think should request a trade soon? I talked about this earlier in the show. I think he's going to Miami. And I think they're going to end up getting one nice veteran player, one good young player, and maybe a draft pick. That's really it. There really isn't a ton that they're going to be able to get for Jimmy Butler right now, unless it's in some crazy four-team trade where they just get one asset from every single team involved. But this is my top five trade destinations for Jimmy Butler. The Heat, the Clippers, and the Nets are my top three. And another player, I think Anthony Davis will end up requesting a trade. I think Kawhi Leonard might also request a trade from the Raptors if the first half of the season doesn't go as planned as well. So watch out for a couple of these guys this upcoming season. Anthony Davis could request a trade, maybe Kemba Walker as well if the Hornets don't end up getting him under contract for next season. Got a question from Landon Hunter. Do you think the Warriors will beat the standings record? No. I don't think the Warriors really care about the regular season anymore. Why should they? Like, there's no reason for the Warriors to overexert themselves. They already broke the wins record once. They don't need to do it a second time. They don't need to prove that again. They're already the best roster possibly ever assembled. I don't really think they care at all about whether or not they're going to break the wins record. But we talked about how the Warriors are the best roster ever assembled. The best daily fantasy site ever put together is FanDuel. And by going to FanDuel.com/chatsports, you can get $20 free with your first deposit. If you just deposit $5, you can end up with $25 because FanDuel is giving us a great deal here at ChatSports. Again, head to FanDuel.com/chatsports. Let's get to our last question here from NewHipHop09. He says, who do you see the Knicks getting next summer? I certainly don't see them getting Kyrie Irving. Not anymore. And if you go on BetDSI today, they're giving you odds of Kyrie Irving not going to the Knicks at minus 595. But overall, I think they end up with Kemba Walker. But that's going to do it for NBA Now. You can follow me on Twitter at Sportsy. Make sure you subscribe to our new NBA channel, NBA Now by Chat Sports. Go check it out for all the top NBA content here on YouTube.